Are you familiar with OData services in your SAP system? Do you want to read and update data in a modern way from the Power Platform? Then this video is for you. Hello and welcome to this new playlist on SAP and Power Platform here on the SAP on Azure YouTube channel. In the preview video, we introduced the new OData connector. We connected it to a public OData service. This time, we want to connect it to a real SAP system. For this first test, we will connect against the public SAP gateway system ES5. If you have not yet registered and created a user, then please take a look at this. Once you have done this, we can use some of the sample services to consume it in Power Automate. So let's take a look. Okay, so similar like before, I want to get started with opening the OData service in a browser. This time, actually, in order to call this URL, I am using my P user to do this and get a list of entities. So you can see there is business partner set, there's product partner, there's product set, sales order set, sales order item sets. So there's a bunch of information that I'm getting back from this SAP system. So again, this is the SAP ES5 SAP Developer Center. Now what I can do, very much like before, I can just here add, for example, product set. And then as a result, I get all these products back from this SAP system. So I get a product ID, I get a category, I get a name of this specific product, and so on. So very much like before, I want to take this information and I want to embed this information in Power Automate. So I'll again go to Create. I select here the instant cloud flow. I'll call this Fetch SAP Products. And I'll select a manual trigger again. So like before, I click on new step, I search for OData, and I can see the SAP OData service. And again, very much like before, we'll start with this query operation. Now, this time, I cannot use the anonymous authentication, but I need to do a basic authentication. So I'll paste in here the URL to my SAP system. I will then provide here my username. So this is my P user. And then I will type my password. So I click on create. And now we have the connection between our SAP OData connector and the SAP system. So which means if I select here this drop down list, I get all the entity sets from this OData service. So very much like before, let's quickly go back here and take a look at the OData service. You can see here the business partner set, the product set, the VH sex set, the country set, and so on. And this is exactly the same information that I see here in this specific list. So what I want to do, I just want to go with the product. So I'll select the product set. And maybe let's go very much like before. Let's go here to the advanced and only look for the top 5 entries. I save this information, click on test, and run this flow. So now we get a list of the top 5 products. So the first 5 products, basically. Of course, I could do a filter or I could a search or something like that. But here I have all the relevant information. I have the product ID, I get the type code, I get the category, all this information that is coming back from the SAP system. Now let's do the following. Now, this time I not only want to read something, but I also want to update some information. So let's say I want to update this specific product ID. And I mean, we could update all the different properties, but what we'll do is we'll just update the price here. So the price is currently 10. So let's see if we can change that. So here's our query operation. So we'll add a new step. And now we want to update the information. So I click on update. I need to make sure that I'm connected to our SAP system. Now, if I take here a look at the dropdown, I want to update a product. So I'll select the product set. And now you'll see something really interesting because the OData service now queries the SAP system for all the relevant products, properties, sorry. And you can see one of the mandatory properties is the product ID, obviously, because we want to know what is the product that we want to update. So I'll add this product ID that I just copy and pasted from our initial query. And then instead of the price of 10, let's increase the price to 20. So just to make sure that everything is okay, let's actually add one more step. So what I'll do here, I'll scroll down here, we'll add one more step. And this time, after our update, we'll again do an OData query, we'll do a read. So we'll not do a query where we get the whole list back of the OData properties, but we only want to retrieve one specific entry. So I select the read OData entry. I will again make sure that I'm connected to the right system. I'll select the product set. Now again, it fetches for the relevant data, because obviously if I want to read one specific entry, I also need to provide the product ID. And that's good. So let's save this and run this test again. Now, what we expect is that the first query returns the information of the product with the price 10. So actually, let's go in here. Let's search for this one. So apparently here we are in the right order. Here's the product, here's the name. We can see down here the price of 10. So that looks good. Then we have the update operation. In the update, we search for the specific product. We provide the value of 20. You can already see here is the price 20. So this looks good, but let's be very sure. Let's look at the last operation, the read operation. And you can see that now the price is, where's the price? The price is 20. And again, just to be very sure that everything is correct, let's do the following. Let's take a look at the product and provide this specific ID. And you can see this is our product ID, and you can see the price has been updated to 20. This is actually super interesting, because a few things have happened here in our Power Automate flow. This update operation typically requires, when you do this via Postman or when you do this in an HTTP request or something like that, it requires two calls. The first call is a call where we actually need to fetch the so-called CSRF token. And only if you provide the right CSRF token with the update call, only then it's actually working. And that's the really cool thing here. And that the OData connector for Power Automate here takes care of all this. It takes care of the CSRF token handling. It takes care of the e-tag handling, which makes sure that you don't by accident override something. So it's really a simplification of how the user of Power Automate can now interact with an SAP system and with OData services in an SAP system.